Hello everyone, a very good evening to all my students. I hope you guys are doing well, and I am back again. I told you that we will be doing MCQs on war poets. I hope all my students are here. Please let me know in the comment section if you guys can hear me and see me. If I'm visible, please let me know that. I'll just check also myself that whether I'm visible or not. I think I am visible and audible, guys. All right. So just a second. Okay. So all right. I can see all my students are here, and we are going to start ahead with MCQ, multiple choice questions on war poets. So guys, in the morning session at 1 p.m. we had discussed about a lot of authors, poets, war poets: Eisen Rosenberg, Wilfred Owen, Seyfried Sassoon, Rupert Brooke, and so on. And we had discussed how pathos, lament, unhappiness, sadness, horror is visible in their poetry, in their work. And now we are here again on discussing some of the major poem, some of the major poem of these war poets. So I'll begin with it. So let's go ahead. I again welcome all of you to India's largest learning platform, that's Unacademy, the perfect study partner for NTUGC NET. And I am Dr. Anamta Rizvi, your educator for NET English Literature. Paper 1 is very important, guys. Please do focus on this paper. It really will help you in gaining a lot of marks. And how does Unacademy work? Unacademy ke plus or icon सब्सक्रिप्शन होते हैं, प्लस पे यू गेटिंग लाइव क्लासेस, क्विज टेस्ट स्ट्रक्चर्ड कोर्सेज एंड अनलिमिटेड एक्सेस. एंड आइकॉनिक में अलोंग विद ऑल दिस यू आर गेटिंग पर्सनल गाइडेंस, टेस्ट एनालिसिस, एक्सपर्ट गाइडलाइंस एंड स्टडी प्लान एंड स्टडी मटेरियल. सो गाइज, प्लस एंड आइकॉनिक कोर्सेज के फीचर्स ये रहे, एंड यू कैन यूज माई कोड दैट इज RIZVI RIZVI10, एंड यू कैन गो अहेड विद द स्लैश प्राइसेज, विद द डिस्काउंटेड प्राइसेज. सिमिलरली आइकॉनिक के साथ भी आप मेरा डिस्काउंटेड रेट यूज कर सकते हैं, RIZVI10, एंड यू कैन गो अहेड विद डिस्काउंटेड प्राइसेस. ओके गाइस, सो द ऑफर इज स्टिल गोइंग ऑन. आप अपना ऑफर अवेल कर सकते हैं 6+2 एंड 12+2. एंड बग्स बाउंटी, अगर इफ यू सी एनीथिंग इनअप्रोप्रिएट ऑन एनी अनअकैडमी वीडियो, यू कैन क्लेम इट एंड क्लेम योर प्राइज. ओके ओके गाइस, स्पेशल क्लासेस मेरी होती हैं एवरी डे फ्रॉम 3 to 4 PM. टुमारो देयर वुड बी स्पेशल क्लास. दे आर इंटरक्टिव, देयर पोल्स फॉर इट, यू कैन रेज अ हैंड, नेवर मिस अ क्लास. लेक्चर नोट एन एनी टाइम एनी वेयर. आपके पास अगर अनअकैडमी लर्नर्स ऐप नहीं है, सो यू कैन गो अहेड, डाउनलोड दिस ऐप, एंड यू कैन यूज माई कोड RIZVI RIZVI10. यू कैन यूज दिस कोड एंड यू कैन गेट अ लॉट ऑफ, यू कैन गेट ऑल द क्लासेस फॉर फ्री. ओके, गुड इवनिंग समीर, गुड इवनिंग भावेश, हेलो एवरीवन. सो ओके गाइस, सो लेट्स स्टार्ट विद आर क्वेश्चन एंड आंसर्स फॉर दिस, फॉर द वॉर पोएट्स. एंड अ फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज एज फॉलोज. Who wrote Dulce et Decorum Est? Okay, this is again World War One poets that I will be discussing. Kisne Dulce et Decorum Est likha hai? Very important question, a very important poem. Wilfred Owen, Rupert Brooke, Owen Shears or Simon Armitage? Question number one. Quickly guys, good afternoon Sameer, good afternoon Bhavesh, quickly, good evening guys. So yeah, all right, let me see who is giving me the right answer for this one. Who wrote Dulce et Decorum Est? Wilfred Owen, Rupert Brooke or Owen Shears or Simon Armitage? Okay, the correct answer for this one is very right, guys. The one who wrote Decorum Est, that's Wilfred Owen. Okay, Wilfred Owen, as we read, Wilfred Owen was the poet jo bahut hi young death hui thi. Seyfried Sassoon ne usko bahut encourage kiya tha likhne ke liye, and he has written some of the very important poems, and unki poem Dulce et Decorum Est bahut important mani jati hai. Okay, so 1A is the right answer. That is your 1A. Okay, Wilfred Owen wrote Dulce et Decorum Est. Okay guys, all right. Yeah, right. Yes Bhavesh and Veena, you guys are right. Moving ahead to the second question. Which war does the poem Dulce et Decorum Est focus on? Dulce et Decorum Est kaun si war ko focus kar rahi hai? World War I, World War II, the Boer War or the Crimean War? A, B, C, D, the options are in front of you. Let me know the answer to this one. Dulce et Decorum Est, jo Wilfred Owen ne likha hai, wo kaun si war ko focus kar rahi hai? World War I, World War II, the Boer War or the Crimean War? All right, very right guys, Polemi and Sameer are very right. It's World War I. Wilfred Owen, we know that he belongs to the World War I period. He died very young. He died through a wound, and World War I ke bare mein usne likha tha. Very right. So Sameer and Polemi very rightly answer, that's World War I. Question number 3. What does Dulce et Decorum Est Propatria Mori mean? Okay, this is the line that comes in the poem. Iska matlab kya hota hai? Dulce et Decorum Est Propatria Mori. What does it mean? Option A, it is sweet and fitting to die for one's country. Option B, it is unfair to have died for one's own country. Or option C, it is brave to die for one's country. Or option D, it is expected to die for one's country. So there are 3 options in front of you. Let me know in the comment section which one do you think is the right answer. What does Dulce et Decorum Est Propatria Mori mean? Alright guys, so Dulce et Decorum Est Propatria Mori, this means 3 and A is the right answer. It is sweet and fitting to die for one's country. Okay, this is the line that comes in Wilfred Owen's poem, and this is what it means, that it is sweet and it is fitting to die for one's country. Okay, moving ahead, 3 is B, Sameer, it's 3 is A, guys. Remember, Polemi is right, and this was the right answer. Next question you have, how does the narrator of Dulce et Decorum Est present war? Choose all that apply. Okay, इसमें आप दो options choose कर सकते हैं कि narrator जो है Dulce et Decorum का वो war को किस तरह explain करता है? Horrific, negative, courageous or brave? Option A, B, C, D. How does the narrator of Dulce et Decorum Est present war? Choose all that apply. Question number 4, whatever it here applies, choose it, all that applies here. Horrific, negative, courageous or brave? Well, in Dulce et Decorum, that is by Wilfred Owen, Wilfred Owen describes this war as very, very horrific and very negative, okay? So that is what he has applied here. So guys, this line that you're thinking, Dulce et Decorum Est Propatria Mori, it is sweet and fitting to die for one's own country, this could be more of a sarcasm, because, you know, this is exactly, it is okay to die for the country, a lot of people believe, but it is very horrifying and it is very negative, okay? Okay, this war. So 4 is A and B. A and B is the right answer here. These two options are here. So guys, 4A is the right answer. Yes, Bhavesh. And it is horrific and negative. Okay. So these are the right answers. Next question we have. In Dulce et Decorum, What technique is used to describe the soldiers in the court bent double like old beggars? Okay, so bent double like old beggars, an important line that comes in your Indulgens et Decorum Est. And so let me know that which of the following figures of speech is come in it: simile, metaphor, onomatopoeia, or personification. A, B, C, D. Let me know, get that in the comment section. Indulgens et Decorum Est, what technique is used to describe the soldiers in the court? Bent double like old beggars. Very simple. Like aa raha hai, aur jahan pe like aata hai, iska matlab figure of speech simile hai. Okay, this is simile here. And I have 4A, 4A is the right answer. Just a second, this is, sorry, ye 5 question hai, 5. 5A is the right answer. So I have Veena, Sameer, Bhavesh and Pitabhasha, all are right. Simile is the right answer. Next question we have, Indulgens et Decorum Est, what does a simile as under a green sea describe? Okay, ek phrase hai, simile hai, as under a green sea, wo kisko describe kar raha hai? The gas fumes surrounding the soldiers, the English Channel, the smell of the sewers, or the army uniforms. Indulgens et Decorum Est, what does the simile as under a green sea describe? The gas fumes surrounding the soldiers, the English Channel, the smell of the sewers, or the army uniforms? Okay, let me see the right answer. Question number 5, and the gas fumes that surround the soldiers, well, the right answer is this, option A, as under a green sea. The right answer is the gas fumes surrounding the soldiers. So question number 6, this is, sorry, I've wrongly named it, question number 6, and the right answer is 6 is your A. Okay, 6 is A, guys, remember this one. It's not D, it's not C, the gas fumes surrounding the soldiers, that is what it is, it is described here. Question number 7, finish the sentence that comes in Indulgens et Decorum, the blood come gargling from the fourth corrupted and dash. Okay, so what will come here? Finish the following sentence. The blood came gargling from the fourth corrupted lungs, heart, mouth, or nose. A, B, C, D, which one is the right answer? Let me know. Question number 7. All right, the sentence, the blood came gargling from the froth corrupted, and the right answer is A, lungs. Okay, that is the right answer, and this is the right answer. That line comes in again the same poem that we've been talking about, Decorum S. So 7A is the right answer. Manoj is right over this. Question number 8 we have, who wrote the poem In Flanders Fields? In Flanders Fields, another again very important major war poem. Ye kisne likhi hai In Flanders Field? Moina Michael, Lady Gaga, John McRae, or the Queen of England? Who wrote the poem In Flanders Fields? Moina Michael, Lady Gaga, John McRae, or the Queen of England? Question number 8. Well, the correct answer is, we know it's not the Queen of England, it's not Lady Gaga, it's not Moina Michael, it's John McRae. Very good. 8C is the right answer. Sameer, Manoj, Veena, Paulami, Raghav, everyone's right. John McRae, A, B, C, D, and C is the right option. Okay, exactly. Very good. Next question we have, when was this poem written? Option A, during World War I, during World War II, during the Vietnam War, or it was written in 2014 on Remembrance Day. When was it written? Question number 9. Very right. This poem was written, we are talking about World War I poets, and this was of course written during First World War, during World War I. 9A is the right answer. Veena, Raghav, Manoj. Nine is A, guys, remember this one, okay? Okay, next question we have, which poem focuses on the horrific gas attacks in World War I? World War I mein bahut horrific gas attacks hue the. Kaun si poem is pe focus karta hai? Dulce et Decorum, as the Deserter, In Flanders Fields, or For the Game? Question number 10. World War II was bloodier and much more terrible than World War I. Lekin World War I mein bhi bahut attacks hue the, especially gas attacks bahut hue the. You know, so soldiers ne iske bare mein, poets ne iske bare mein bahut baat ki hai. So 10, can anyone talk about it? Which poem focuses on the horrific gas attacks in World War I? Very good, guys. The right answer is Dulce et Decorum Est. Very right. That focuses, we know that it's nabhi green gas ke baare mein baat kiya tha. We just read it, and this focuses on that. Question number 11 we have, which poem acts as a tribute to those that died in a battle? Dulce et Decorum, The Deserter, In Flanders Field, or For the Game? Question number 11, read it carefully. Which poem acts as a tribute to those that died in a battle? Dulce et Decorum, The Deserter, In Flanders Field, or For the Game? As a tribute to those who died in battle in World War I. Well, question number 11, and the right answer for this one is, the poem which acts as a tribute to those who died in a battle, and the right answer is option C, In Flanders Field. Okay, it's not D. A lot of your answers D, but In Flanders Field, it's a tribute to those who died in a battle. That's by John McRae, who wrote Flanders Field. Question number 12, who wrote The Deserter? Okay, another poem. Ye kisne likhi hai? Wilfred Owen, Winifred Letts, Thomas Hardy, or John McRae? Question number 12. Question question number 12, who wrote the poem The Deserter? These all poems that I'm discussing here, guys, Dulcet Decorum Est or Flanders Field or the Deserter, these are all very, very important poems. Just to make sure that you know it well. So who wrote this poem, The Deserter? Question number 12. A, B, C, D. Winifred Owen, Wilfred Owen, Winifred Leeds, Thomas Hardy or John McRae. And the right answer is very good, Sameer. That's Winifred Leeds. Winifred Leeds was the one who has written The Deserter. Okay, next question we have. Question number 13. Okay, question number 14. Which of these poems focuses on World War One? Which of these poems focuses on World War One, Dulcet Decorum, In Flanders Field, The Deserter, or all of the above? Which of these poems focuses on World War One, Dulcet Decorum, In Flanders Field, or The Deserter? Very right. 14 is D, because all these poems talk about World War One, Dulcet Decorum also, In Flanders Field also, The Deserter also, and all of the above also. Very good, guys. Question number 15. Which poem focuses on death being inevitable? Inevitable matlab unavoidable, death ka certainty ke ki death to honi hai. So kaun se poem focus karti hai death being inevitable? In Flanders Field, The Deserter, or Dulcet Decorum, or For the Game? Question number 15. Very right, the poem that focuses on death being inevitable, question number 15, and that is The Deserter. Guys, 15 is B. The Deserter focuses that death is going to be inevitable. The Deserter by Winifred Leeds, jisne likha hai, that focuses on death being inevitable. Question number 16 we have here. Which poem focuses on death being brutal and truly awful? Kisne bataya hai, kisne baat ki apne poem mein ki death is truly awful and very, very brutal? Dulcet Decorum, As the Deserter, In Flanders Fields, or For the Game? Question number 16. The poem that focuses on death being brutal and truly awful, well, that is 16, and that is C is the right answer. In Flanders Field, it has been discussed that death is very brutal and death is very awful. Remember, guys, death being inevitable is discussed in The Deserter, and death being brutal and truly awful is discussed in Flanders Field. Question number 17 we have. Which poem focuses on death being a soldier's duty? It is a way to stop more lives being lost. Okay, ye kisne likha hai? Kaun si poem mein bola gaya hai ki soldier ki duty hai to die? Dulcet Decorum, In Flanders Field, The Deserter, or all of the above? Question number 17. Question number 17. Which poem focuses on death being a soldier's duty? Question number 17, and in Flanders Field, guys, 17 is your B is the right answer. 17B, in Flanders Field, it has been discussed, it has been talked that, that death being a soldier's duty, it's a way to stop more lives being lost. Okay, this is the right answer. Question number 18. Who wrote Who's for the Game? Ye poem Who's for the Game kisne likhi hai? John McCrane, Wilfred Owen, Winifred Letts or Jesse Pope? Question number 18. Who wrote Who's for the Game? John McCrae, Wilfred Owen, Winifred Letts or Jesse Pope? Question number 18, guys, quickly. Very right. Who's for the Game has been written by Jesse Pope. Very good. Sameer is right. 18D and Manoj, Polami, Sameer, Janani, Veena, everyone is right. Jesse Pope was the one who wrote Who's for the Game. Next question is, Who's for the Game uses which political method to interest people in war? Who's for the Game कौन सा technique use करता है ताकि लोगों का interest जगा रहे war में? Propaganda, debate, evaluation or instructions? Question number 19. Who's for the Game uses which political method to interest people in war? Correct answer for this one is, Who's for the Game uses which political method to interest people in war? And the correct answer for this one is, okay, so question number 19, and the right answer is propaganda. Propaganda is something जब आप उसको उछालते हो, कोई propaganda, you know, एक method, एक calculative method use होता है to entice the people that war is a good thing, war से, you know, country का bravery होगी, country का इज्जत reputation बढ़ेगा. So this is the propaganda that, you know, war के time पे इस्तेमाल हुआ था. Who's for the Game talks about propaganda, okay? So this is the right answer. 19 is A, guys, okay? Next question we have is question number 20. Which technique is used repeatedly in Who's for the Game? कौन सा technique repeatedly इस्तेमाल हुआ है? Alliteration, metaphor, rhetorical questions or similes? Question number 20. Question number 20, and the right answer is, guys, the technique which is used repeatedly in Who's for the Game, and the right answer is 20 is rhetorical questions. Bahut rhetorical questions. Jab itna bada topic war ka istemal ho raha hai, guys, rhetorical question is matlab ki question lagta hai, lekin it's a statement in itself. So rhetorical questions have been asked a lot. So in Who's for the Game, rhetorical questions have been asked. That's option C. 20 is C. So very good, guys. Veena, Polami, Vijayanti, it's 20 C. 21 question. How is war presented in Who's for the Game? War kis tarah se present ki gayi hai Who's for the Game mein? As fun, enjoyable and honorable, as tiring, और एज बोरिंग और एज टेरिफाइंग एंड पेनफुल. वॉर का डिस्क्रिप्शन क्या दिया गया है इन हूज फॉर द गेम, एज फन एंजॉयबल ऑनरेबल एज टायरिंग एज बोरिंग और एज टेरिफाइंग एंड पेनफुल. इन हूज फॉर द गेम, well guys remember Jesse Pope's who's for the game and the correct answer for this one is the war is represented as fun, enjoyable and honorable. Yes guys, this is the right answer. It is very, you know, rhetorical question that I'm saying ke pucha gaya to, so you know, as fun, enjoyable and honorable, this has been there in this in who's for the game. How is war presented in who's for the game by Jesse Pope, that is as fun, enjoyable and honorable. Okay, next and last question we have, how is death presented in who's for the game, as inevitable, it's hardly mentioned or as something to be feared or it's slow and painful. Question number 22, ABCD, how is death presented in who's for the game, as inevitable, as hardly mentioned or as something to be feared or it's slow and painful. Yes guys, 22B is a right answer. It's hardly mentioned. Death is not talked about in host for the game, and that war is taken as fun, enjoyable, honorable, and it is host for the game, it's hardly mentioned. So guys, with this we are coming to our end of the MCQ on war poets. In my special classes I will be doing more questions on war poetry, so please be there tomorrow for my class from 3 p.m. to 4 p.m. that will be special class, that is totally free on an academy platform. So for this guys, thank you for today. Please like the video, share with your friends and subscribe to the channel, and I will see you all tomorrow for sure at 1 p.m. and again at 6 p.m. and also at 3 p.m. for the special classes. I will be taking more special classes and I will let you guys know about it. Okay everyone, thank you so much. Have a good day, have a good night, and keep reading and keep studying. Thank you so much.